specimen we
have to capture. Yay. What this means, you get to dissect an energy slash crystalline being. I don't know how that works.
I thought I'd already done that. I guess I hadn't.
You hadn't collected
them. Oh, yeah, no, I shoved a shotgun the last one's ass, didn't I? Yeah.
Yeah, no, yeah.
Wow, how did you not remember it? That's why you have such a high opinion of yourself, yet you selectively forget your failures.
Oh, no. He has people around him to remind him of those.
Yeah. I forget all kinds of things, Dirk. It's not just the bad stuff.
Yeah, he forgets the good stuff, too.
Yeah. Mm. All right, so these people talk because it's going to move the plot forward a little bit. I'm going to cut them off here, not to be rude. Get a new sweater, fella.
And by the way, I remember now, it's acts like this that progress the story in the game. So be prepared for worse enemies.
Yep. Yep. What the hell are you, Lenny Turtletob? Oh, yeah, I'm going to take the improved defense. All of my guys need as much defense as possible. Yeah, weapon fragments. That's good. That's good. So, situation room doing? Ah, god damn it! Quit talking.
All these people in your base with the sweaters just make me think, hey, it's like Mr. Rogers running the place, which is pretty great actually.
Ah, days remaining. 0 days remaining. So I'm about to get my thing, but I'm gonna have satellites. I just won't be able to complete the Canadian request for satellites. Excuse me. Balls.
But you got 2 light plasma rifles.
Did you get any money for completing that side quest?
No, I don't know.
Or just the privilege of dissecting an energy being?
I think it was just the privilege of dissecting an energy being. My own people don't give me too much money.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Sign Speaking of dissecting things in an underground military base, has anyone ever seen the new James Bond movie?
I haven't.
I haven't seen the new James Bond movie.
Sorry.
Okay. You're kind of cutting in and out.
I guess I need to hire someone to replace. Yeah, fuzzy face. Oh, I need new names. What's the name of Bojack's girlfriend?
I got. So let's see. Did we do his parents, Beatrice Horseman and Butterscotch Horseman?
Okay, we can.
And meh.
Vincent Adultman is dead, isn't he?
Yeah.
Man, why would you do that?
The method actress. You need to do her.
Oh, yeah, Margot Martindale. We've been putting that off.
Margot, so you know her name. Okay.
Yeah.
Celebrities. Martindale. Okay. Wallace. Oh, it's actual people.
Yeah, that one is.
Well, all of them are. Like, the celebrity section, they're all voiced by themselves.
Yeah.
Oh no! No.
Well, not Beyonce or the Secretariat. Beyonce is Yvette Nicole Brown, and the Secretariat is John Krasinski from The Office.
No, that makes sense because the Secretariat's a horse.
Well, a
famous horse. Woo!
That's good.
It's good stuff. But seriously, what's that owl's name?
The what?
Oh, Bojack's horseman's girlfriend in season 2. She's an owl, so there's probably an owl pun in there.
Probably an owl. Bojack is slowly. No, that's slowly. See, growls. Wanda Pierce, an owl who is in network television. Does that sound right?
Yep.
Well, I guess there wasn't.
She woke up from a 30-year coma and began a relationship with Bojack. There you are.
Yep. Doesn't know he's famous because she was unconscious at the time.
Wanda Pierce is voiced by Lisa Kudrow.
Yeah, she's great.
Yep.
Great in this.
Yes. They do a lot of great owl jokes. More specifically, her turning her head 180 degrees.
Wait, why are you naming a male Wanda Pierce? Oh, because you're not getting any females? What the hell?
I don't give a fuck.
You can't choose them.
We just got four new recruits. Two of them were female, two of them were male, and we named them after three women and a dude. So I don't care.
Wow.
Obviously.
Do you have any control over their genders?
I don't know if I can change their gender or not. I'm not like super curious about that. But let's find out for science.
How progressive.
That seems to be the only thing I cannot change about them. That and when they die. I have no effect on either of those factors.
you can definitely hedge your bets as far as when they die.
All I can do is change some numbers, Derek. But when God comes for them, nothing I can do. All right, we got abductions. Time to dig ourselves a little deeper down this hole.
Oh, what do you mean deeper? Every body makes the hole more shallow.
All right, so Mexico's hard. I get a support sergeant, which isn't bad. South Africa, which isn't very bad. Very difficult one. I get four engineers, but I don't really care about engineers. France, which is difficult, but I get $200.
That's why your equipment's all faulty.
Because I'm broke?
No, because you don't care about engineers.
Look, I have enough engineers to build stuff, but even if I did build a foundry, and even if I did have the money to pay for the stuff that would come from the foundry, like, I just don't have the money. Am I wrong in that assertion? Can I just, like, spend engineers to get stuff better?
I can't tell you that you get more monthly wages if you have more satellites over places.
Yeah. All right, but fine.
What about... Sorry.
I'm taking options. You can see Canada and the U.S. are a little unhappy. They may be more unhappy if I don't go to Mexico. Africa seems okay. Egypt's a little cranky. But they seem fine. And then finally you have Paris... And the UK is a little unhappy, and Germany is a little unhappy. So, options.
So let me ask you this: when everyone's in full blown panic or withdrawal, can you like win back their approval, or like once it's done, it's done?
I think once it's done, it's done.
Okay. Well, I mean, right now you're just kind of managing fallout around. I guess so. Whatever maintains the most of possible resources, I would do that thing, regardless of mission difficulty.
Any thoughts, Richard?
I just think it's hilarious that Canada and U.S. both want you to go to Mexico.
They're both what?
Both want you to go to Mexico.
They do. They're all on the same continent, so.
But, I don't know, man. I don't know too much about how the logistics about the game, so I couldn't tell you or argue against manpower versus cash flow.
Okay. I am going to go with, I'm going to go with France. I have alien grenades?
Yay!
This was going to work out perfectly for me.
I'm sorry, but I just got a flash of like you throwing a grenade and killing two of your people in the process.
Not inaccurate. We all did. We all had that. All of us had that. That went through all of our minds.
Even yours. Rocket launcher.
Yeah, it didn't go through your soldiers' minds.
It will.
It was the shrapnel that went through your soldiers' minds.
Ah. All right, I got one recruit here. Merely a difficult mission. Can I drop my extra heavy?
That's even better than grenades? Alien grenades.
they gotta be, right? They gotta be better.
Yeah. You know, would an alien make grenades designed to kill aliens? Hell yeah. They haven't even met humans. How would they know what to make them out of?
He makes grenades designed to kill humans.
It says alien grenade. If it said human grenade, it would be labeled differently.
All right, we're doing a bug hunt. Hopefully without actual... I hope it's like two sectoids on a sick day. But like, I don't feel good, but I'm going to go in anyway. I'm just out of sick days.
Sick days.
Just walk up and shoot them with a shotgun.
I would like to point out, Chris, when you get the plasma sniper rifles, it's basically a heaven gun.
Why would they even make those? Anyway.
What's a heaven gun? It's just really good, I guess.
It's a Family Guy reference.
American Dad.
A very adequate Christmas special. It's where Stan and dies when their car gets caught in a snowstorm. And he goes up to heaven. Finds out that he's got to go on trial to see if he deserves to be in heaven. And that his family is going to freeze to death because he was too stubborn to listen to anyone else.
Uh-huh.
So while on trial, he pulls his gun out to try and take people hostage. Like, we're already dead. Your gun does nothing. So he grabs one of the bailiff's guns. That's a heaven gun. It can kill anything. Why would we even have those?
This is so great. That show is a treasure.
Really? I thought it was the opposite thing.
Well, we'll just have to agree to disagree.
Yeah, well, no, that's... I knew that before I said it, all fairness.
American Dad got better. Family Guy got worse.
That is true.
The Clueless show is... its own bailiwick. I'm not going.
It's over.
it is no longer. It ceased to be.
It wasn't that bad. It just wasn't that great either. I never hated it. You know, I'd watch it.
Yeah, I think that's the one thing that I think that's how I feel about American Dad. I didn't think it was like it wasn't horrible the way Family Guy I felt was horrible, but it was great. Like, it didn't keep my attention either.
I look at American Dad as this. Their bad episodes aren't that bad, and their good episodes are really effing good. The Vietnam reenactment episode.
It's the best one. It's called In Country Club. It's great.
Yeah. So, Dad, you're taking us to war reenactment? Like what, the Civil War? Nah, these guys are hardcore. They reenact Vietnam.
Oh, man.
Yeah, good times.
Classic. All right, I guess I won't send Herb Kazaz up the left side all willy-nilly because people keep telling me to keep my troops together and minimize casualties.
I imagine you said all those things with air quotes, whether you did or not.
No. You could hear the air quotes.
But I definitely feel as if I could hear the air quotes.
Yeah. See, I'm imagining he's planning on doing the exact opposite. So he's going to cluster all of his people way too close together. We've seen how that turns out. So either way, I'll laugh.
Chunky salsa.
Chunky salsa.
Yeah, that turns out.
What's going to look like? Woohoo, just some thin men. Good. Milk Run. No problems. I don't run away.
I just charge right in to start shooting. Sorry.
Yeah, oh, God. Yeah. They were hiding the true force. I'm really looking forward to the Deadpool movie.
Yeah,
it looks fun.
Mm-hmm. And that's what I'm hoping for. Fun. It doesn't need to be anything else.
Yeah.
And even if they've already showed the best jokes in the previews, which I don't think they could because, you know, ratings and you know, such.
Yeah. I definitely don't think the best jokes are in the previews.
They're still,
especially since they've been so religious about making it a rated R movie. Well, not, I mean, yeah.
No, no. It works because religious starts with an R.
Oh, that's a groaner, Terry.
I know it is. I'm a dad, Richard. I can do these things. I'll show you my license.
Touche. Touche.
His license is verbal. He just has to tell you at least 4 dad jokes in succession.
Yeah, without any help from his friend Chris.
You're my bro, yo.
The fuck? What no-look fucking bullshit was that?
Ooh, I can't wait to see the no-look bullshit.
Everyone, pay attention to the screen. Anytime now. He's still moving.
Yeah, one of those flying guys just point behind. Whoa, that is some no-look bullshit. Did he just shoot through the corner? Like,
he just shot through like 2 walls to kill my dude.
And nailed you. Nailed you for 3 damage. That's something.
How much damage can that guy take?
About 5 pips. More.
That's another thing, okay. Too, is it looks like you can make your own entries, so maybe not going through the doors is not a good idea.
It's a little quieter. Ideally, it would actually...
You have to have something to shoot at to kill people.
Swear to God,
oh, but yeah, because you would have the fog of war inside for the whole thing. I get that. Okay. Nice.
Yeah, this hasn't turned out too badly.
I'm still watching him aim the grenade. There we go. All right, it's a rocket. Yeah, boom! It's a
rocket. Wasn't quite everything I'd hoped that it would be. But,
Yeah, well, that's what the thin man said, too. Well, that wasn't everything I hoped it would be.
Really hoping that my sniper would have a better shot at these things.
Up to 4 damage. Bam. Done.
Boom.
That dude is suppressed like a mofo.
Yeah, he's pretty well suppressed. I have no urgent need to kill this thin man, so I'm just going to let it ride.
Yeah.
Wait, say again?
I have no urgent need to kill this thin man, so I'm gonna let it ride.
Fair enough. I guess the suppression looks more dangerous than it is.
It does, actually.
It makes me less accurate, and he gets a free shot on me if I do anything. So
it's a good time not to do anything. Hunker down, baby. Hunker down.
Get that sweet, sweet defense, man.
We are doubling down, sir.
Oh, that dude's jacked. He just got wrecked.
Mm. Oh, I had a fun little thought, Derek, for Demon the Descent.
Uh-huh.
All right, so you know the base of the God Machine. It's some kind of strange overarching, possibly computer intelligence, like an occult computer or something. That manipulates esoteric laws of physics to get its end results.
Interesting.
Well, combine that with the theory that the reality is actually a computer simulation.
Uh-huh.
And it's just a hacker that's breaking into the system and using back doors to do what it wants. And demons are just or angels are just viruses. Well, demons are viruses. I guess the angels are. Anyway, I liked the overall concept, because as that makes the World of Darkness an MMO. So, you know, vampires and werewolves are just DLC characters.
DLC.
Don't you mean premium content?
Premium content, thank you. I guess having a werewolf with a hat would be DLC.
Oh, you want a pattern on your fur? Yeah, that's going to cost you $5.
I still love the demon powers.
Yeah, I mean, when we kind of walk through the game, it seemed pretty cool to my thinking. Mm. For sure.
I like how their powers are very, their specific powers, like embeds, are very esoteric and limited in scope, but that just means you have to be creative with them.
Yeah.
you know, like devil's advocate, the one that lets you basically make a statement and the person you use devil's advocate on immediately takes the counter stance to that statement. So the example they give is if you get pulled over by a cop and he's tell him, you should give me a ticket and take me to jail, officer. Devil's advocate. No, I shouldn't. Get out of here.
Yeah. You can't tell me what to do.
But that's cheating.
Although the new one I've read out that I really like is, I forget what it's called. Oh, wait, it's Apple of Discord. And basically, if you touch an object or person, you can make that person, anyone that views it, sees it, or the person or the object, gain an obsession with it. So I just want to take things and go, you want this.
Yeah. Well, just like take like just some piece of, you know, like a pin out of your pocket and be like, listen, I will give you this pin in exchange for your your credit card information.
What was it? Oh, and other things like what's it called? Just Bruised. Basically, yeah, you use it, and whatever attack you take, you only take one damage from it because you're just bruised.
Nice.
For some reason, it makes me think of Dr. McNinja when he gets shot with with a machine gun and has like 50 bullet wounds, and he survives because, as he tells Death, they were all just flesh.
What was that thing that he just jammed to the ground, the Thin Man?
I do not know.
Is that something you should worry about?
I don't think so.
Famous last words, I guess.
Look, I am more confident. This is the confidence I have from paying attention to things. This.
I'm pretty sure he's just summoning Cybermen, so he'll be fine.
Like he's born into a door.
Yeah, he doesn't have Krill on his team, so it'd be good. Everyone else can take Cybermen.
No. Krill, remember, Krillin kills four of them. It's Yamcha that can't handle Cybermen.
Oh yeah, Yamcha can't handle Cybermen. That's right.
You guys just left my bot there.
I got whatever way works for you, buddy. If you got to go over the river and through the woods to jump over a potted plant, you do that.
Don't judge.
Oh, good. I'm only suppressed.
I have to say, Dragon Ball Z Abridged is still got that quality going for it.
Oh God, how much do you like the Cell?
Fantastic. Did you see the recent episode?
Which one is that one?
Oh, it's where...
I don't know.
Well, no, that's kind of what it was, yes. It's where Vegeta's going to let Cell eat Android 18. And Trunks intervenes. I love that.
Yeah.
What are you doing? Throwing near my plans? You know what? Yes, I am. And then blasts Vegeta. I love that bit later on when Vegeta's floating in the ocean and he's floating there going, huh, this is a new feeling, pride in someone other than myself, shamed it's overshadowed by this unbridled rage.
Well, like, why would that alien choose to suppress you when he's got like clear line of sight?
I
do not know.
I think the Thin Men are kind of. I think the Thin Men are kind of support, so they'll tend towards more of the suppressive type actions. At least when they're in groups.
Yeah. Fire the gun, jerks.
You're a soldier. You do two things: aim, fire. God, send you back.
Shoot, move, communicate, kill.
Oh, wait, did I dash somehow?
I don't know. I'm seeing the past right now. Let me see what you do.
Yeah, because I opened the door so I could take the shot, and then I suddenly stop acting.
Isn't opening the door part of an action?
I really don't think it is, but I mean, apparently.
No say, man. It's a good time to do, though. Hunk it down.
Yeah, that suppressed dude should definitely hunker down.
I'm so suppressed right now, you guys.
Or if you can, move further back for cover.
All right, see, and now I have line of sight to three guys, but I cannot fire for some reason.
Oh, is this your sniper? Could that, is that
no,
it?
No, it's no. Just a guy. It's just a guy with a gun.
Guy with a gun. Oh.
Switch to the pistol. Bam. Switch to the machine gun. I can fire again. That is fantastic.
Oh, well, weird, but hey, hooray.
Pressy McGee, take... What the fuck was that?
Okay. I'm looking forward to the future.
Fire pistol.
All right. Everyone, just run into this room and shoot people with your guns. Just run into the room and shoot people with your guns. That's our new plan.
Suppress the wall.
Suppressing fire.
Yeah, it looks like he tried to shoot.
What the fuck? I specifically, I don't know if I'm losing my mind here, if I'm just paying absolutely no attention.
But, little column A, little column B.
Yeah, apparently, because like I should have had the shot with that guy that just, no, I guess he did dash. All right, that's fair. But
also, your chances to hit are shite.
Yeah, why is Lynn just chilling out by the fountain?
Because I,
he's a turtle.
When the jet guys popped over, they were on the left. So then I shot one of them down, and the other one jumped to the right dramatically. But I'd already repositioned Lynn so they could take sniper shots at those guys, which apparently did not happen because they moved. So.
Well, I thought you had. I thought there was another round between now and then.
Holy fuckballs! Like,
okay. I'm looking forward to this as well.
No, it's just the ricochet shot.
Yeah, I saw the shotgun shot. That went well.
That was good.
Well, you killed the thing. That's a good thing.
Yeah. I mean, it was insignificant, and you still got one squatty that's probably going to bite it.
I don't know. Do you have a grenade? Like, these guys look like they're in prime grenade range.
They are in pretty good grenade range, yeah.
You're right. All of Chris's guys are in grenade range. It's fantastic. It's like he planned it this way.
Hold on for a second. If you use a grenade, does it replenish the next fight, or do you actually use it forever and have to make another one?
I don't know.
No, you get a new complement of grenades every time.
Okay, good. Because I was about to say, that would be ball sack. If it was not the case,
it's all sacks, pokies.
Well, no one died, so we'll take it.
Good stun. Simmons stun.
Thank you.
He's about to get dissected. Don't shoot. What are you doing?
The things you're protesting already happened, Derek. You're only catching up to
You're like, it looked like he was about to shoot his own teammate.
There's no friendly fire in this game. Thank God.
Oh, I thought, only if they panic and stuff is when you can do that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Suppressing fire.
Hey, you got Herb Kazaz as lieutenant.
Yep. He's an actual officer now. Statistically speaking, he's going to die.
The great curse.
All right, so how boned are we?
Super boned.
Rather boned. Well, apparently, when they hit five, they don't just pull out, so it's good for Argentina.
Have you done Sextina yet?
What's up?
Oh, Derek's apparently going.
I'm leaving. Take care.
All right, later, dude.
Bye. Good night, all.
All right, I'm going to put this satellite over Argentina. Because I think it will give me money, and then it will also keep these guys from pulling out.
That's one thing Argentina never does, pull out.
All right, look, their panic already dropped. So it gives me 5 days. I mean, yeah. So that is fantastic. things aren't as bad.
Actually, looking at it, they're pretty bad.
Why you? I don't have you naysaying my team.
Everything I create, you piece of shit.
Everyone's out of the hospital.
Hooray! It's great. And who's not out of the hospital? BoJack. Yeah, he did.
God, quit being such a Debbie Downer.
Is that a character? You should have a Debbie Downer on your team.
I don't think it's my character. Look, we can do SNL characters once we're done with whatever comes after the BoJack characters.
Well, we'll be at that for a while, but I have faith in you, Chris. I have faith in you.
All right, I have 241 Zorkmans now.
Woo! You're practically rich, depending on what those translate to. RuPaul's? Damn it.
All right. So I can buy more standard... I can buy laser rifles.
Laser rifles?
Yeah. Like, instead of my standard assault rifles, they're laser assault rifles, which will be better. Let me go to my laser science. Beams? Huh?
Lasers.
Laser beams.
Yeah, I saw a movie. They seem to be pretty effective. I mean, they definitely see. It definitely seemed like armor did nothing for anyone.
Ever. Yeah.
Yeah.
Titan armor is probably gonna be my next move then. Oh look, I have that interrogate Muton on my to-do list. I hope he's patient. I know I made this joke yesterday, but Richard wasn't here. It's like we're just letting him walk around the facility. He's getting coffee. Any word on that interrogation, Muton? Nope. They say it's going to be tomorrow, but they said that all week. Someday, Muton. We're going to rip you apart. We'll get to it. Steam facility is real tempting, too.
Oh, in the Forced Awakens book?
Yeah.
When they get the shields down on the planet, you know, with Phasma, Captain Phasma? There's more banter, and they use Chewbacca the Threatener, and she goes, like a Wookiee could take apart our First Order armor, armor, and he proceeds to break one of her pauldrons. Nice. I'm like, and my first thought is, have you been paying attention? The armor, it does nothing. It's like it's goggles. The goggles, they do nothing.
Oof. Well, 118 Zorkmids. Put a 1 and 2 zeros behind that number, and you've got yourself a mission. No? I'm still going to go.
You add 2 zeros in front of that, and then you have a deal. What you get me? 200 Zork meds.
Yay. Zork meds.
If you're not clear why he's calling them Zork meds, it's because they've got that funky not dollar sign symbol. That,
oh, yeah.
Like him, I only ever see in legal documents. So I assume it's like UN currency. Here, this is backed by no country. Bye.
Chris, yeah. I've noticed that some of them have names that are in quotation marks. What's up with that?
They get nicknames.
After they reach a certain level, they get a nickname. I need to change Herb Kazaz's. Horsing around. Aww.
To give you some background, Richard, Herb Kazaz was the writer for the sitcom that BoJack starred in, and they were also really good friends. And up until El Herb got cut off from the show. Oh, I forget what for, though. Was it because he was gay?
He was gay. It was okay. The 90s, man.
That's true. So they found out he was gay, and they cut him from the show, because they needed to keep their image up, and that's not cool.
It was a family show, yeah.
Oh, and BoJack totally bitched out about on it.
Yeah, like it's not and, like any, anyway.
Yeah, and then afterwards just never got in touch with him, just cut all ties.
But BoJack was the star of the show, so that if he had walked, they may have kept Herb around if he threatened to walk. But he wanted to be in a Secretariat movie. The Secretary is his hero. And so the executive in charge is like, maybe you don't want to make waves, because maybe people who make waves don't get to be in Secretariat movies. So he kind of said nothing. And then the Secretariat movie went into turnaround. So he didn't get anything that he wanted.
I'm sorry, Chris. That's just way too much Hollywood lingo for me. I'm just a plain and simple guy.
All right. Caught in an explosion. Simple this Minerva Bridge. Backwater planet.
Who thinks your eyes is corn? but this, you know, I'm just a plain and simple hyper chicken from Hollywood. which is also one of the best running jokes in the show. After BoJack steals the Hollywood, the D from the Hollywood side, and it's decided that since it was done for love, they're going to leave it that way. So it becomes Hollywoo, and everyone calls it Hollywoo after that.
Oh, they actually give a reason for not putting... No, I thought the D just went missing, didn't it?
No, they found the D. Remember, Mr. Peanut Butter takes credit for it.
Yeah, it was at Mr. Peanut Butter's house, but I don't think they ever got it. I think it got dropped off in the ocean, didn't it? The guy crashed because of the... He crashed, and that's how Todd got out of jail.
That's right. He did crash.
Todd was in jail for a while.
Yeah. that character you don't know, Richard? He was in jail for a while. He did some time. Anyway.
He was using BoJack's house to give tours, pretending it was David Boreanaz' house.
And they'll put up with that kind of stuff in Hollywood. Oh no, your deep worst nemesis, a bridge level.
Alright, one. I didn't lose anyone on that bridge level. Things went okay on that bridge level.
Elevated highway, whatever. No, I'm sorry. I must be remembering some alternate reality where you had a total party kill on a bridge level.
Or maybe it was.
We'll call that timeline B.
Oh right, that was a shotgun. That was not effective. So
it's a shame you don't have ways of knowing what things are.
There was 50% odds I was gonna take it.
Those Thin Men react hilariously. Scatter! They're like
no idea what their deal is. Cover well though.
Well, they all suffer from anorexia for one. It's a crippling condition of their species.
Yep, and more Thin Men.
But fortunately, they make up for it in numbers.
Fortunately for who?
For Thin Men? Ah.
God damn it, do not shoot at my target. That's right. Let's get right there. Right there is going to be perfect. Perfect place for you to be. So, oh, wow. They've got Kelsey Jennings pretty well flanked. She may not make it through this turn.
No, not Kelsey Jennings. You could throw a grenade at one of those cars.
No. No. Okay.
Kyle, what?
Oh my god, General. Shut the fuck up. Kelsey Jennings may be about to die, so just take the fuck and shut it up.
Ouch. It was good knowing you, Kelsey Jennings.
One of you bitches has run and gun.
In front of the same car. Oh good, didn't shoot Kelsey.
I know, right? How lucky was that? Oh, wait, 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 no. God damn, damn, god damn.
Oh.
Whoa, what'd I miss?
I ran up and shot one point blank, forgetting that they explode whenever you shoot them to death.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's a thing that happens.
Then how did the San Andreas Fault just crack?
Are we in a different aliens level? Did it.
Oh, okay.
If it's XCOM, that's a pretty safe bet.
Aliens did it, huh?
Yeah, aliens.
Whoa.
Run?
Okay, well, that worked perfectly. Ah, shit, there are aliens left. Don't die. Don't die down there. Oh, do not even harry me on this, fool.
Now is the winter of your discontent.
Yeah, heal yourself with some wounds. Oh, thank God. Okay.
Terry. Eh? You might know like this. The other day I was at work, and I actually found an intact second printing of Advanced Dungeons & Dragons Player's Manual.
Nice. At work?
Yeah.
As a prop? Yeah.
Well, it's not a prop anymore. It's in my damn library.
Very nice.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's see. I think it was printed on... Yeah, sixth printing, sorry. 1980.
Still. Jeez.
Yeah.
Good condition?
It's been through the ringer. Oh. The pages are in good condition, but the outside, it's seen better days.
Mm. It's okay. It's got that lived-in look everyone's into.
Yeah.
Oh, is it? There's a podcast I listen to. It's called RPPR, Role-Playing Public Radio. they mostly do actual plays, but one of the other things they do is after hours talk, and they review sometimes they review game books, and this last one they did was a AD&D game book from like 1984, where it's one of those that's so you've got high level game. Your characters have gone as high as they can. They're now basically gods. But, you know, this is back when they couldn't call characters gods because, you know, religious people and concerns. So they became immortals. They're basically the lowest tier on the totem pole. And it's completely crazy, AZ Gygaxian in a world. It's like they wanted to make a different game. But they still had they used D&D as the model. everyone has crazy powers, but it doesn't really matter much since everything they have to do is even crazier. It has one of those covers that looks more like it should have been airbrushed onto a van.
Nice.
Everyone is ripped. The men, ripped. The women, ripped. The double men, double ripped.
Now this is, I'll hold it up to the camera if you want to look at it. It's really, really crappy looking.
Cool.
All
that Overwatch paid off.
Yay! Huzzah! Something you did paid off. Amazing.
It's a rare and beautiful day.
But the adventure consists of the universe is going to be destroyed unless you collect the essence of five senses into these enchanted daggers given to you by higher ranking gods. The mission literally is, you know, here you go to these because you guys are new. You're our work bitches. And don't worry if you it's understood that don't worry if you fail, we'll just send somebody better than you. So you travel the multiverse to find the essence of sound, sight, and taste, and et cetera, et cetera. Oh, and smell. The funniest one is going to find the essence of smell. Smell, yes. Because it takes you to this mysterious world magic. You're on Earth. and your D&D character, and while you still have some powers, most of them aren't there. Good side is, because of your super high intelligence stats for being immortals, you can figure this world out pretty darn quickly. There's actually rules. If you get into a car, if you have instruction, you can figure out how to drive it in 3 rounds. If you don't have instruction, it takes 6. It's crazy. If you have an hour's time, you can figure out how to speak the native's language.
Oh, damn. All right. Forgot they could do that.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, they can spit poison at you.
Oh, the thin men? Yeah. Yeah, they're venomous, remember? They're reptilian. They're snake people. In the next game, they're literally Naga.
Oh, nice.
Really?
Yeah, they turn them into Naga people. It's a whole cobra thing. They also get the grabby tongues, as well as constriction. Yeah, they basically go, "Hey, remember the thin men? Yeah, this is what they look like when they actually bother to eat. put some meat on the bones." Yeah, it's a hilariously crazy adventure. One of the guys really enjoyed the essence of sound, because you go to the realm of music, where you literally a two-dimensional plane with where you're on a sheet of music.
Hmm.
There's a lot of music puns, like you follow a note, and if you go too slowly, he complains about losing a rhythm.
You're off key.
Yeah, or so, yeah, like that.
Kind of bullshit.
Yeah.
Wow.
The other bit they do regularly is traps, because there's an old AD&D trap book done like, and they review and mostly mock the traps. My favorite one was. Okay, here's the setup. So first you need to have some sort of bowling alley in your dungeon. And and what it is it's designed kind of automatically to where if people come in and bowl, they get gold coins equal to the number of pins they knocked down. But after the third ball I'll return, they stick their fingers in, and the holes in the ball actually have poison needles inside. Right.
And the
review, how'd the review go? The guy said, "Well, first of all, what kind of crap dungeon doesn't have a bowling alley?" Or another fun one too, because you know this is the era of dungeon crawl hall D&D, where it might as well all start and end with you going through the dungeon, searching everything, because you're there for the loot, man, precious loots. And this one is a small tunnel, like an air vent. Yeah, that's tightly spaced, where you could, once you start crawling, you can only move forward or back. There's no standing up or turning around. And as you crawl forward, it gets a little tighter until you come across these rubberized wheels on the top and bottom of them. And as you move forward, they press against you. And once you put enough pressure on them, it activates the trap. They spin and send you shooting forward at 60 miles per hour into a spike wall. His complaint there was, this is ridiculous. The walls are only spikes. They're not even poisoned. Why not a wall of fire spikes? So it was funny, very reminiscent of the ridiculousness of old school D&D dungeons and adventures.
In the game that I'm playing right now, I found the original second edition module for Ravenloft, and apparently someone updated it with all 5th edition rule sets and everything. So we're running that. And apparently this rule set also included a deck of many things in there.
Of course it did.
Yeah. So
we're just going to label this in the box of do not touch.
Yeah, we found it. And well, one thing, we also have a character, a guy who's not exactly all there. I mean, he's, I don't know, just dumb. And he's gone through, I think he's going to be on his 4th character if we don't find him. And by don't find him, he decided to pull from the deck of many things first. We had like a night of downtime that we just mess around with.
Right. Now, just to clarify, is the player not all there, or is the characters not all there?
The player, if you got 4 player. Characters.
Okay, that's player. That's what I figured, but I wanted to be sure. I didn't want to prejudge.
Yeah.
No casualties.
That is a terrible victory call.
Look, once that's not such a big deal, we are going to get a new one.
But until then.
Woo, minimal injuries.
Yeah. So anyway, first thing he did was pull, the Donjon card, which immediately encases him in imprisons him in a bubble, stark naked, somewhere to the DM's choosing. No one can figure out where he is unless they expend a wish spell or get help from the deity. There's absolutely no way to find out where he is.
Well, good luck finding one of those in Ravenloft. A deity, that is.
Yes.
Isn't the sign leading there going, "Abandon gods, all ye who enter here"?
I don't know.
Anyway. No, it's just a joke, really. But it's a dark setting is what I'm trying to say.
Oh, yeah.
All right, yeah, so I guess he's on a 5th character then.
Yeah. What other stupid nonsense have we found? I mean, the guy's obsessed with having a cart and a wagon. And last time it was awesome. They were eaten by ravenous wolves at the beginning of this particular setting. And the next had a donkey. Which we left for like, I don't know, 3 days tied up to the outside of an inn.
Mm-hmm.
He's dead.
But, well, that's what happens when you don't feed or water your donkey.
Yeah. You get a saggy ass. I recently was able to pick up all 3 of the new Star Wars books. Those are kind of an interesting read. Mm-hmm. Yeah, good. I mean, everything is, they have their own dice system, which is absolutely unique.
Not most unique. Sorry, it's based on Warhammer Fantasy 3rd Edition.
Oh, really?
All right. Yeah, they have their unique dice system in that one, too. I'm sure it's different, but it's where they got that from. Fantasy Flight's the game company. I've heard good things on it, though.
It's very freeform, as far as I've read. Also, the default setting is the Rebellion period. Everybody's fan favorite.
Mm.
And why wouldn't it be their fan favorite?
Ah, crap. I need engineers.
But the fun thing is, it took them 3 core books to actually come up with actual rule sets for Jedi characters. And the whole idea is, you're not a Jedi, you just found something that is like a book of Jedi facts. Philosophy. You're trying to emulate it to the best of your ability.
Yeah, you found like a Jedi's old holocron porn collection. Oh, and his. It was Jedi porn.
Yeah, but it's actually pretty interesting.
That's the way good.
They deal with it.
Because
everything.
You have careers,
classes.
I was just gonna say I have to I appreciate that because in the prequel games, well, you know, it, everybody wants to be a Jedi. But yeah, no, like career classes.
Yeah, every each book is of the three books are focused on one specific aspect of Star Wars. The first book is you're like the fringes of the galaxy, so it's all about criminal organizations and just being out in the middle of nowhere, that kind of shit, trying to survive. The next one deals with military aspects, so you're going to be dealing with rebellion. So you've got all kinds of classes based on that. They're very similar to each other. I mean, you have some that are based on cavalry, some that are based on diplomacy, some based on either stand-up combat or ship-to-ship combat, that kind of stuff. And each career is going to have multiple specializations. Like if you want to go, if you want, say you want to be a smuggler, you can be either an ace pilot, a thief, or the scoundrel class, which is all about deception and, you know, fast talking and shit like that. And, you know, all their different talent, the talent trees that go with them focus on those things. And then once you get into the Jedi core book, you're basically going to be different types of Jedi, and only one of those specializations has anything to do with a lightsaber. And they finally give you a skill for it. And it's kind of interesting because each specialization is a different fighting style, it turns out. Like each career gravitates towards a different style of fighting. And default attribute would be strength, but if you try a different attribute, you go up, you can actually start using cunning or intelligence or even charisma for your default attribute. So it's kind of interesting that way.
Sir, you want some Phoenix cannons.
What's a Phoenix cannon?
It's a cannon, Richard, that shoots Phoenixes. I told you about thinking. Just tiny Jean Grays flying out of that sucker. The Model 2 is Dark Phoenix cannon, but it's a little unstable. Wow. On a roll tonight. Anywho, no, that's cool, because that is similar to the, like I said earlier, the Warhammer Fantasy 3rd Edition that they did. Because they also had the career system. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was a little more specific to this. I mean, it was of course specific to the setting. So your base careers were all kind of shite. Let's see. I think Chris, what did you play? A rat catcher?
Me? What? Yeah, no, rat catcher at first.
Yeah, yeah. I think you were moving into assassin after that.
Or academic. I forget.
Yeah, but I think your end goal was assassin, at least.
Yeah, it was.
One is I'm going to graduate to people.
Yeah, he had a pet cat. Although the default is a dog, but whatever, it works. Dwarves can train a cat. They've got nothing but time. But yeah, they had the careers, and they went from ranks 1 through 5. Now, the first set of careers were very basic. The second set, that if you chose one, you could continue along the same line. Mm-hmm. Assassin could lead to something even more assassin-y. I forget what it was called, though. Or there were a few that were like that from the start, like wizard or initiate, which is priest, and... there were 5 ranks worth of wizard stuff and priest stuff. But either way, the highest ranking ones, of course, were the most badass. So you could start off as a rat catcher, but end up being a merchant lord or head of thieves guild, or just a really badass soldier, or a wizard.
Not a lot of alien incursions.
Well, after that last one, they're rethinking their strategy. All right, we can't expect them to just kill themselves and walk into our death tunnels.
I tried, damn it. I tried.
Has any of them, has your base been invaded yet? I know it's like a random thing. Or possible thing.
I thought that was only in Fallout 4. I thought Fallout 4 was the only game that did that.
Actually, I don't recall if that's a thing or not, Richard. At least I don't recall it happening to me. But I haven't played this in a couple of years, so. Although that made me, when you said that, all I could think of was Mass Effect 2. I'm like, no, that's Mass Effect 2.
Yeah.
But we kept joking. Okay. Let's see. But yeah, no, the new Star Wars stuff, I like it. I like that dice system, even if it is a little difficult to do on the fly.
Yeah, well, the way I understand it, I mean, the whole thing is basically it's a storyteller dice system. The whole idea is that it's done on the fly.
Mm-hmm.
Or the whole idea is that you don't have to worry about hard numbers, just how awesome do you succeed? How less awesome do you fail?
Yeah. What do the dice say hey, happens? How do you turn that into something?
Yeah.
It's a fun way of doing that.
I'm worried about my satellite capacity. My new satellite capacity. Not be opposed to Star Wars. Here's the deal. Panic in Europe is so low, I'm just going to blow this one off.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that where your home base is?
Yeah. Crap.
Sometimes I'm really confused by the people that follow me on Twitter.
Marketing.
Yeah, no, it is. But still, the weirdest marketing. I just got followed by some MMA fighter. Oh, and world arm wrestling champ. Proud father. Also living with depression, brain injury, and mental health issues. Interesting. So, that explains how you can be a proud father. Aww. I got dark. Anyway.
All right. Oh, I need a new another BoJack character.
Ah, bugger. Have you done Margaret? What's her name?
Yeah, Margot Martindale. Yeah, I got
Margot. Yeah. Okay. Have we done Bill McNeil, the Navy SEAL?
Oh, we haven't done Neil McBeal.
Neil McBeal, yes, the Navy SEAL. Who is also a SEAL.
Kind of looks like a black Frank West.
Huh.
I can see that.
He does look a bit like face. A gorilla. Give that guy a plasma rifle. Thank you, sir.
He's my support character.
Yep.
Oh, has any of you guys... Any of you guys watch that new Jessica Jones show on Netflix?
Yes.
I haven't finished it, so...
Yeah,
but
okay, where
just,
are you at right now?
It's the episode after they stuck everybody's favorite doctor in the in the doctor.
In the glass cage.
Yeah.
In the sin bin.
Yeah, the that's sin, the episode. Yes.
The sin bin. Yes, it's a good one.
Oh, yeah, they just left Trinity to watch him. She's just farting around on Facebook all the time.
It only gets better from there, really. It only goes up.
Really?
It only goes up.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, so far, it looks like if you strip out all the Marvel BS, it feels like the whole series is basically like an in-depth view of an abusive relationship and how it spreads out into people that know them, like the abuser and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Yup.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's pretty great.
And it wasn't until the previous episode when they finally said, "You raped my mind." not just my whole my body, but also my everything else.
It's like, oh, I don't like that word.
I mean, the episode where she has to live with him, where she kind of lives with him for a while.
Yeah.
Pretty good times.
We finally get as much Purple Man as we want.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm just saying, he's a great character. He's an awful character. And being that intimate with him, you see how awfully great he is.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, and then where he has the next-door neighbor come up with, oh, hi, you're that cop? Here, this is I was supposed to give this to you, and it's a fucking bomb.
Yeah.
So great.
And not only is it a bomb, she explodes, and you see body parts for like 5 minutes.
It is gruesome. But the best part is that, you know, he was planning that since the jump.
Oh, yeah. And that with his 8-hour limit on his, or 12-hour, 8-12-hour?
Yeah, it was like whatever. 12 hours.
Limit on his, with his powers, he's got to set all this up ahead, so it also showcases him as a rather intelligent guy.
Yeah.
Or at least good at planning that, most of the time.
You know, he's all, oh, I can change. I'm not just a sandy little butthole, but he's planning to have
good South Park movie reference.
Yeah.
He's planning to have the cop killed, like, even while all that's going on.
Yep.
Such a delightful piece of shit.
Yeah, and then they include an a very underplayed Marvel character and make him interesting.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, give me a red one.
Kilgrave?
Kilgrave, yes, but I mean, really, Jessica Jones in general is like C characters for the most part. But the cop, Al Simpson.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's a he first appeared in Daredevil, as a part of a super soldier program with the pills. You see. Wait, have you seen him take the pills yet? No, you wouldn't have. Shoot, I'm sorry.
No, that's all right.
Okay.
Ignore us. But yeah, no, he's what's his name in the comics?
His name is Nuke.
That's right, Nuke. Very subtle.
He does seem to be very trigger happy.
Yeah.
And likes to use explosives.
He gets worse.
Yeah.
Or better? Yeah. Anyway, you'll like this Turvins, but he was a surprise character. I recognized him by his name because he was in one of the Death of Wolverine comics. They had him in like one of the intro comics that I was listening to. I didn't read the comic, I just listened to a review of it because apparently it's kind of shite. But at any rate, he's a little known character in the Marvel universe.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of comics, not too long ago I picked up the entire tome of the Spider-Verse comic event.
Oh.
That was weird as hell.
Yeah, isn't that the one with the dimensional traveling wasp guy that eats Spider-Man?
Yeah, he's like one of Moreland's family. Well, they all eat spider people, but there's one of them that was banished, and he apparently goes around trying to, like, wearing a big-ass version of, like, the Man in the Iron Mask that makes him look like a Big Daddy from Bioshock.
Huh.
Yeah. You know, just wearing, like, a dapper suit. He's got a trident or some crap. Yeah. Anyway, but he doesn't like having to feed from the spider people. And one of the other things, the Moreland family is able to track down and predict the spider movements because they also have a spider totem guy in a web. He's got like this mechanical spider bottom, like a thorax or abdomen or whatever you want to call it. Anyway, the weirder thing is, you know, you get to see a spider pig, and they don't kill him. Like, he doesn't die from that. Apparently, there's a version of Spider-Man who is British and is in the Captain Britain Corps, and he's blonde.
As you do.
What else? This was also the one.
Oh, I was saying, didn't they have like one alternate Spider-Man that never gave up the power of Captain Marvel or something?
Yes. Yeah, he's like their big heavy hitter, although I think he ends up dying. Or maybe he just gives up the power, leaves him. My comic book is here. They did introduce fan favorite Spider-Gwen.
Spider-Gwen.
Yeah. Oh, damn.
You're saying.
It's good times.
Yeah, it sounds like a pretty crazy one. What are you doing here, Chris? Jumpy people, they're doing jumpy things. Something's going to happen here. You laughed a lot. Missed.
One of them decided to suppress me from a car that was burning about to explode.
We learned that in Fallout.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you do. You do.
I hadn't read Spider-Man since before the Civil War comic, and apparently apparently he's become, I mean, I know about the whole Mephisto thing, and because I did listen to some of the blogs from Chris Sims, which that's another topic about
one more day
in a second. After the one more day DS, apparently he got his brain was taken over by Dr. Octopus, and thus we had Superior Spider-Man for a while. We had Dr. Octopus in Spider-Man's body.
That seemed pretty cool.
Yeah. And
nothing weird or strange about that at all.
Yeah, that ran for a while, and I guess Peter got, fought back eventually. And the two of them, pre and post Doc Ock Spider-Man's fight, and Superior Spider-Man gets his ass kicked. He's superior, but not really.
That makes sense.
They bring back or make relevant Spider-Man 2099 again. Yeah.
I don't see how that could be possible, but go on.
Well, it's all right. He didn't die or anything.
And apparently now in the current canon, Spider-Man is like a CEO of his own company.
I heard about his own
tech company. Yeah, Parker Industries. He has gadgets like Batman.
Yeah.
They kind of always had gadgets. It just didn't have budget.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, now he's got budget. His gadgets now have holograms.
Yeah. How's that line go? Hey, you're that chick that stole my shoes. You know, the things are like $80. Give me $80.
So the other thing I wanted to mention, especially for you, Chris, did you hear that Chris Sims got accused of like sexual harassment or some crap?
Yeah, he harassed some lady on the internet, and then he did the smart thing. He put out an apology that could have been better, and then he kept his head down for like a month, and then everything was cool.
Okay.
No. These things go.
Really? He didn't just double down?
No, he didn't double down.
They usually go the other way.
Yeah, no. He's smart enough to know what's up. People were not happy with his apology, but that's the thing that happens. So, I think he was totally being a jerk about stuff, but given that he was a jerk and he wasn't just going to stop being alive and Chris Sims at the same time, he made the best moves he could. So,
That's fair.
Yeah.
Oh, are you ever going to throw this grenade, Kazaz? Ever?
I'm just trying to get it right. But I do throw it, and it works out just fine.
Way to spoil it. I'm done with this. But no, for me, the screen stuck, so...
I think this is going to be my last mission for the night.
You just hover in there. Yeah, that's fair.
Might want to log off and log back on.
No. If you're done, you're done. That's cool.
No. I'm still in the middle of this mission. I'm still at it.
Mark Hamill looks a lot better without that beard.
Without the beard?
Oh, really?
About what?
Makes yeah, I just think so. Bad. I mean, he
beard
without the beard. It kind of does. Also, his in some reason it just makes him look angry. Well, his face makes him look angry.
Yeah. That's weird.
Little Hans, or. Harrison Ford does look happy.